WWE Hall of Famer Mick Foley, and you are listening to the WNS podcast. Yeah.
You're listening to the official Wrestling News Source podcast. For all of your information, go to WrestlingNewsSource.com or check us out on Facebook by searching WrestlingNewsSource.com or WNS Podcast. You can also find us on YouTube, Twitter, Stitcher, and iTunes by searching Wrestling News Source Podcast or WNS Podcast. Now being broadcast in over 45 different countries, here are your hosts, Daniel Herron, Tyler Hebert, and Doug.
That's right. What's up, everyone? I am Dino Herron.
I'm Tyler Hebert.
I'm Doug.
And we welcome you to episode 289 of the official podcast for WrestlingNewsSource.com. For all of your information, go to WrestlingNewsSource.com. Check us out on Facebook, WrestlingNewsSource.com. You can find us on Facebook, WNS Podcast, on YouTube, WNS Video, and on iTunes, Wrestling News Source Podcast.
289, huh?
Yeah.
Dang, we're getting close to 300.
289 episodes, 11 more to go till we reach 300.
Ooh.
Spartans.
Yes. We're on Stitcher, Beyond Pod, and Player.fm. Just search Wrestling News Source Podcast to find us.
You can follow the podcast on Twitter at WNS Podcast. Daniel's at WNS underscore Daniel. And Tyler's at Tyler underscore Hebert.
There you go. So welcome to the show. Got lots to talk about this week. A lot of fun events that occurred. Got some feedback. Talk about Raw, SmackDown, Hot Topics, Q&A, all the good stuff. Maybe some more. How you guys doing?
Not good. You
not
know
good.
Why?
Why is that?
Because WWE 2K17 is not here yet.
Not yet.
Not yet.
It will
and
be
you
soon.
Know, and it's going by slow and it sucks.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
It'll be all right.
No. That's every, one thing I'm looking forward to.
Every little ting.
And you know what?
Is going to be all right.
And it's not going to be a letdown when it gets here.
Yeah?
I know for sure.
You seem confident.
Yes.
Have you seen like the new... ladder match style game that they have.
Yeah, we'll see how that works. I've seen the gameplay. We'll see how that plays
out. We will
out.
See.
We'll see.
Yeah.
But I'll talk about more about that later.
What's going to be the first matchup that you have on that game? Who will you play as, and then who are you going to play against?
Thought about this.
Yeah?
Already. And I can't decide.
Deep in thought.
AJ or Shinsuke, but I'm leaning more towards Shinsuke.
Mm-hmm.
Because I've read and heard... different things on the internet by people who was at the 2K event, and they said that for DLC is like Shinsuke. I mean, also Shinsuke is like on point with his entrance and everything, and he just looks great. And I'm like super pumped. It's like what you see on TV is exactly what you see in the game, and I'm super pumped. We'll see.
Yeah.
We'll be the judges, but that still has got me hyped.
Yeah. So.
But it's gonna be like one. Those would be one of my okay. If I'm not Shinsuke, I'll be AJ. If I'm not AJ, I'll be Shinsuke, and then I'll fight the opposite.
Are you just going to like put AJ on one side of a coin, Shinsuke on the other side of a coin, and just flip it, whichever one it lands on, that's who you're going to play as?
I should do that.
Okay. That's probably the easiest way.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
But which name is going to go on which side?
I don't know.
Should you flip a coin to determine which side AJ's name goes on and which side Shinsuke's goes on?
Yeah.
Yep. Okay.
Yeah, that's it.
So you've already decided AJ's name is going first.
No, I don't know.
Okay.
No, I have not decided.
So should you flip a coin to determine whose name is going to go first?
Nope. I'm just going to put it on the side of the coin. That's all I'm going to do.
Oh, okay. Doug, how are you doing?
I'm pretty good.
Yeah.
A little tired. A little bit of real life getting in the way, but...
yeah, that's no fun.
Be all right.
No bueno.
So, we going to be all right.
Yep.
Every little thing. He's gonna be all right.
I'm gonna kick life.
I was doing more of a Kendrick Lamar thing, but that'll work.
More Bob Marley.
That'll work.
Because I've been to Jamaica.
Have you been to Jamaica for real?
I have. I went there from part of my honeymoon.
That's right. Well,
yeah.
When you say your honeymoon, I just assume like in my head it's like, oh, they run on a boat for a while. So like, I don't know.
I don't think you've seen the pictures from my honeymoon, have you?
I don't believe so.
You should come over one day. I'll have to show you. We'll set up a slideshow.
All right.
It'll be fun.
That's so. Certain times, I think life should be a person so I can super kick it in the jaw.
That would be nice.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe Scott Pilgrim. You know, if your life had a face, I would punch it.
Yeah.
That's what life is all about right now. Punching it in the face. Kicking its ass.
Super kick.
taking names, super kicks. Before we dive into feedback, we do have an iTunes review. It's always nice to hear from our listeners. This one is a 3-star review from GoGo White Sox saying, enjoyed you guys until Doug started talking. Nobody likes a know-it-all that knows nothing. Ooh. So, at least thanks for listening to the show. Sorry it wasn't up to your forte. I don't know. Doug, comments? Questions?
I don't want to drive down the ratings. So I'm gonna, no. I mean, obviously, it's true that I don't know any. I don't know everything, but I don't think that I said anything in a way that was intended to present itself as I knew everything. But of course, I don't know everything. But yeah, mm-hmm. I mean, it is what it is. I mean, like, I do not desire to appeal to everyone who listens, nor will I appeal to everyone who listens. Yeah. I was interested, like, what pissed him off. And you know what we were sort of talking about this before the show, and I was like, I don't even feel like I had any, like, really strong, like, opinions about anything last week. And then it came to me as we were doing the intro, I was like, I bet he is pissed off about the Bobby Roode stuff. I was like, that's, like, the strongest opinion I had on anything last week. I bet this guy likes Bobby Roode a lot, and that's probably what it was that pissed him off.
Yeah.
I don't know. It is what it is. I mean, you can feel free to not like me. I don't know. Is that a fair, is that a fair for review for not liking 1/3 of the show?
I don't know, because
if we got another half star coming to us, then I want that half star.
I don't think we've ever, none of us at any point in the show have ever claimed to be know-it-alls or we know everything that's going on. I think quite the opposite, actually. We constantly say, oh, I don't really know for sure. But I don't know. I mean, we appreciate you listening.
Yeah, I'm not going to back away from like speaking passionately or really hammering home my points just because it's going to possibly offend some people. It is certain to offend some people. It is certain to people are going to listen to anything that I have to say on any given show and turn them off. I've tuned into podcasts just to try them out and being like, yeah, that's not for me. Those guys aren't, or those girls, those whoever's are not coming from, like, what I, you know, expect people to come from. So it's whatever. I mean,
yeah, I would, you know, not necessarily that it's a requirement, but I would like to maybe hear from GoGo White Sox about what topic maybe he disagreed with you on, or if something he felt differential towards. You know, and if that's the case, we'd invite you to go to our Facebook page, WNS Podcast, and just leave us a comment there and be like, hey, it's me, GoGo White Sox. Here's where I disagree. Here's where I think this, you know, because we love hearing other people's opinions. And then we'll, you know, we'll process that opinion and give you our response to it as well. So, you know, from there, maybe you can see Doug's side or maybe he can see yours. So if you decide to give us another chance, feel free to take up that offer. Go to our Facebook page. Give us a little bit of your 2 cents.
Give me all your 2 cents.
But thank you regardless for listening to the show and taking the time to give us a review. So yeah, thanks. But let's dive into feedback. First bit of feedback we have is from James saying, I just looked up Cody Rhodes clip from Evolve 66 and 67 because Doug said he wrestled. He turned down an invite to join the former WWE group of Hero, Galloway, EC3, and Chuck Taylor.
Whoa, that is what happened. Dustin. What? All caps.
What happened? What?
Huh?
He's Dustin in all caps. That's his new name in Evolve. It's not Chuck Taylor. It's Dustin.
Really? That's hilarious.
Because Chuck Taylor's dead, and all you morons killed him.
That way said.
Pretty much.
That's awesome. Okay, so
I didn't know such thing.
So when was he part of WWE?
No, they're doing this.
Maybe he
like
just joined in.
They're doing this like, we're proud, we're indie and proud of it versus, you know how Evolve obviously has a very close relationship with the WWE now. So the good guys are like, we work with the WWE, and the bad, like the we're proud to be independents, piss on them, are like guys who left the company. And
yeah,
stuff.
That's
like,
what I thought. But
yeah,
but
so it's like Galloway, EC3.
Or well, Dustin.
They just brought Dustin all caps.
All caps. I like that.
They just, Galloway.
Now
just,
is it just Dustin or is it literally Dustin all caps?
It's just Dustin, but it's stylized like in all caps.
That's Dustin!
Dustin. Yeah. Dustin. I like that. That's awesome.
But Galloway brought him in sort of as a, like, he, you know, like he has a relationship with like Gargano, and Gargano is sort of like leaving as like one of the main focuses of the company, you know, and it was that kind of a thing. So, yes, he hasn't been with the WWE, but he is like a counter to Gargano, I guess, is how they rationalize it or whatever, even though Gargano's on his way out. But
I want to tell you, I've always liked Dustin.
He's a good dude.
Dustin!
I like Dustin! That. I like that man.
So good stuff. Thanks, James. Final bit of feedback we have is from Ace McSpade saying, another fine podcast, gentlemen. Nice work. So thank you very much. Appreciate it.
Thank you, sir.
So
I'm glad that whoever checked out of all of them, I guess he just saw the video. I mean, you should watch the show and let me and
James.
See James and see how you feel
hey,
about the
have
product.
You seen that thing? I don't know what promotion it is, but it's going to be in Arlington. It was like, I know like the main event's going to be like Chris Hero versus Cody Rhodes. But like AR Fox is going to be there.
Arlington, Texas?
Yeah. There's going to be two events. There's one on Thursday and there's one on Friday.
Of this week?
No, in September.
So there's time to go.
8th and 9th, maybe, I think.
Yeah, it doesn't sound like a day I can make, but I would love to see Hero.
That is pretty cool. And there were some other people. I'm blanking who else, but there were some other people that.
Sure, it isn't like Inspire. Like Inspire usually brings a lot of people.
I thought it was. It has some people, but it had a different name. I'll find it and I'll show you.
Okay.
Cool. But yeah, so thank you for the feedback. We always appreciate it. Let's talk a little bit about Raw because Raw was taking place in Houston this past week. We were unfortunate to not be able to go. Had to sell my tickets. And
I'm glad I didn't go.
Yeah.
Because I had a bug that hit me late night,
that's right.
Monday night. If I had that up there, I would have been, vomiting in the other end.
Shitting?
Shitting. Oh, we can say shitting.
You
okay,
can say shitting.
Okay.
Well,
not diarrhea. Can't say that.
Can't say diarrhea. Yeah.
Can't. You don't say the P word. We're
in
good.
Your...
Poop!
In your vehicle.
Not my vehicle. Hell no.
In your vehicle.
No.
All up in your vehicle.
We would have stopped. So, yeah, you got a stomach bug. I ended up having to work late. Doug, I'm sure you had to work late as well. So, and plus that drive back that night would have been butcherous, and having to get up early for work the next morning would have been
butcherous?
A pain.
Is that a word?
Yeah.
It is now.
Right. Butcherous?
Is butcher okay? Maybe I'm the asshole. Maybe I just don't know what I'm talking about. I'm trying to real smoothly call you out about it. I'm Googling it right now.
You go ahead and Google it. As much as I would have liked to have been there, I'm kind of glad that I wasn't because
it's a motherfucking word.
Dude. Boom. Oh, you just got learned.
See, that's what happens when you. That's why nobody likes to know it all. Who doesn't know anything. See, I'm just proving go-go.
I am good with the words.
I'm just proving go-go Sox guy the right man. Fuck.
Go-go White Sox?
Whatever.
Yeah.
Some kind of socks.
Doug, are you happy or sad that you did not go to this particular Raw?
I mean, I wanted to go regardless if it was,
Big show?
Yeah, a big show like them crowning a new Universal Champion or if it would have just been like another... run-of-the-mill Raw, I would have liked to have gone either way. It's just like work is the problem.
That whole life thing gets in the way.
Being an adult and whatnot.
Sucks.
Adulting.
Yeah. To all of our younger audiences, stay young as long as you can. Save up that money. All that good stuff. But
I mean, you guys are dancing around this Kevin Owens shit. Let's just get into it.
Yeah. KO.
Go ahead. I'm gonna jump in and try not to talk so much so I don't segregate more of the audience.
New champion, Kevin Owens.
You know, like I said last week, I did really my heart wanted Kevin Owens, but I expected Rollins or Reigns to win it.
Yeah, and
I did not see Triple H coming in.
Yeah, neither did I. I was kind of wondering how they were gonna. To make that happen if they decided to pull the trigger for Owens, which I'm so glad that they did.
A lot of people are pissed because Triple H got in there. It won't bother me. It doesn't bother me.
It doesn't bother me either.
Because I feel like, I know Kevin Owens can do it by itself, by himself, though, but say if Triple H backs Owens, I mean, he's going to, and then that turns Rollins' face. I mean, I don't know what they're going to do with Reigns. I don't know.
It's interesting that it didn't bother you guys because I have a huge problem with it.
Okay.
I mean, I'll say that I want to be clear and not know it all that I'm happy for Owens. I think he was the right guy to give it to. I just don't like how they got there.
Mm.
And the problem that I think is that, for one, the only guy who was properly eliminated was Cass.
Yeah.
Who they let shine early, so like everyone worked really hard to make Cass look like a big deal before he was eliminated.
Yeah, he took like all the finishing signature moves and all that in order to take him
out.
That
was good for them, but essentially Triple H got like pinned two guys and he wasn't even the match, essentially. And the problem, I understand people are like, I mean, who cares, but where I... For one, I think it sucks that Owens had like his sort of crowning moment overshadowed by Triple H's involvement so heavily. And even if I feel like there is a way to do what they did and accomplish Owens going over, like I felt like they could have did a turn there if they wanted to, where Owens could have been a babyface. Mm-hmm. Now, obviously, they want a babyface Rollins, so that's not the plans. But I felt like he could have. You can still do the Triple H Rollins stuff and still have Owens win on his own and still have Owens not be the guy who aligns with Triple H. I guess like the part of the reason so many people are high on it, other than just liking Owens, is I guess people are high on the fact that he's like the new chosen guy with Triple H. But to me, that's a big problem, because I think if you look at why so much of the WWE feels so blah is because we're such lacking in star power. And like, if you look at who you consider to be like a star and who has like a star power aura in the WWE, it's like Brock Lesnar, it's like Undertaker, it's like Triple H, it's like John Cena, it's like Stephanie, it's Shane, it's Daniel Bryan. And the huge problem with all that is those are like largely non-wrestling talents and part-time wrestling talents.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And people can say like, it's not a big deal. But they did the same thing with Seth Rollins. You could argue they invested heavily in Seth Rollins as like a guy, right?
Mm-hmm.
But so much of his run was so hand in hand with authority that he doesn't. And look where Seth Rollins is. Does Seth Rollins feel like the star on the level of John Cena or Brock Lesnar or even Stephanie or Shane or anyone who they present as real stars?
No.
So why do we have any reason to believe that Kevin Owens is going to feel like a big star? I mean, you could say that Owens is good enough to overcome it, and he may be. It's not a for sure thing, but if we're looking at history and we're looking at track record, we don't have like a historical like reason to believe that he can overcome it.
I wonder if like the backstage thought process is, it's like, oh, okay, Triple H can help make stars by always being in a situation. I don't know.
Don't get it twisted. He's going to lay down for Rollins at WrestleMania, but is that going to make Rollins a star, or is so much of... Because, I mean, maybe you guys feel differently, and I like Rollins as a talent. I think he's a good wrestler. I think he tries hard. I think he works hard, but he doesn't feel like a star to me. He just feels like another guy on the roster to me. And, of course, he doesn't feel that way in the same way that, like, Dolph Ziggler does. He feels like a higher-on-the-totem-pole guy on the roster, but he does feel like just another guy on the roster. He doesn't feel like a Daniel Bryan. He doesn't feel like a Triple H. He doesn't feel like a Stephanie.
I agree with you.
Isn't it a problem that Triple H and Stephanie and Shane are, like, such big stars, but no one on the roster is? And that's probably why people are so bored with seeing them, but they don't let anyone else get over to that level. Like, and I'm not saying that he would for sure be a huge star if he won on his own, but it's a better step than like where I think than where they landed. And I'm not saying Owens can't overcome this. He's talented enough too, but maybe he can't, you know, who knows? I just feel like, and I guess they're going to keep him heel because they want to do Rollins as a babyface. And I'm sure like once they do this mini feud with Rollins, Sami Zayn's going to come out and be like, motherfucker, I already beat you. And they Hell in the Cell. It's going to be fucking nuts. And we're going to be tripping balls at the Hell in the Cell between Sami Zayn and Kevin Owens. It's going to be a fucking awesome match, I'm sure. But I felt like you could have branched off Triple H and Rollins and then turned Owens babyface in a way that like it was organic in the match by overcoming the odds by Triple H trying to fuck him anyway. I just felt like there was a better way to do it. I feel like there is too much track record to showcase that this is not going to actually help Owens, and he may overcome on his own again because of his own talent. But man, I just feel like I want some of these guys and girls to achieve like a status that they feel like they can't achieve because too much of the focus on the show is Triple H or Stephanie McMahon or Shane or Brock when he's there. And I'm a huge Brock mark. You guys know that. But I mean, some of these other people got to start feeling like those guys. That's why everyone's so blah about the product. And hopefully he does. I don't want to feel like I'm bashing him. I think I said at the beginning, I think he's the right guy. And I'm happy for him. I just don't like how they got there. I don't know.
I'm just going to also see how everything goes after this because I still feel, I'm okay with it. I see your point. I'm still okay with it. But I want to see how it goes from here. If it really heavily relies on Triple H.
Well, I'm definitely intrigued. They definitely left it open. Like they teased the tension.
Owens looked shocked.
Yeah, he looked like he didn't know. They teased interaction with him and Foley, Foley being what's up with that. They also teased Stephanie not knowing what was going on. And maybe that's just her playing along, or maybe it's not, or maybe I'm intrigued to see where they go. I just don't know that this was the best way to make him the guy. I don't know. I mean, maybe I'm wrong. I'm hoping to be wrong. I hope he's the biggest fucking star in the past since Daniel Bryan. Who knows?
That'd be awesome.
But I don't know. I don't know that I like it the way they went about doing it.
I'm okay with the way that they did it because, in a sense, it's going to take Rollins out of the title picture for Owens to go up against a face while Rollins focuses on Triple H.
Oh, I don't think they're doing that.
You don't think so?
Well, I think he's going to feud with Rollins short term and then move on to Sami Zayn, and I think that Triple H is going to keep fucking with Rollins, and the end goal is him and Triple H at WrestleMania.
See, that's kind of a long stretch.
I know.
So, what I thought what was going to be the first thing? I know they already did it, but whenever he took Reigns out and kicked him and stuff like that, I swear I was like, "Oh, okay. We're going to have a Triple H Reigns thing again." I was like, that's what I thought, but not to be.
Yeah, it was kind of weird that he came in and took care of Reigns to the delight of the crowd. Then he turns on Rollins like that. But I don't know. It's one of those things where something that we've talked about for so long about how the WWE has had so many chances to make a star, and they would never pull the trigger. Look at your Rusevs. Look at your Bray Wyatts. Every time that they had a chance to really give them the good shine, to make them a big star, they said, no, we're not going to do that. Sorry, it's just not your time. And then, you look at where they are now, and, Rusev's doing pretty well. Bray Wyatt, I don't know, not so much.
Rusev's doing well in spite of what he's been given.
Yeah.
Rusev's doing better than Bray.
But I mean, you look at guys like Cesaro, who, the crowd wants to see succeed, and WWE, for whatever reason, decide not to pull the trigger on that one. They have stars there. So when you look at a guy like Seth Rollins, out of all the guys on the roster who are getting shine, Seth Rollins is above everyone else. Now, is he that main event caliber? I would think so. But is he to the starhood of, like your Shane McMahon, Stephanie, Triple H? No. And that's because they want to be on top. Stephanie wants to be on top. Triple H wants to be on top.
Because they like
Vince
on
wants
top.
To be on top. Yeah, they like being on top. That's right. So,
but I think that's a problem with the product.
Yeah, and that's something that we've talked about for a long time. They've relied so heavily on Orton. They've relied so heavily on Cena. They've relied so heavily on Undertaker to be the main draws that they didn't spend any time building up new stars for this generation.
Cena is, I don't know what's going on with Cena because he's doing dark matches and stuff or whatever. But
yeah,
he's
taking time off so that he can record that reality show season 2 or whatever that he
or
did.
Is about
competition.
To.
Yeah.
Well, Cena's a different argument. It's fine for Cena to be the star that he is because he's on the roster. He is a wrestler. You need more people like Cena,
Yeah, and they've refused to build those stars.
Yeah.
Now, like you said, you could have left Triple H out of the equation and had Kevin Owens become a star on his own. But, they did what they did. Nothing you can change about that. I think they were really hoping that they were going to build a star in Finn Balor, and then, of course, an injury occurs. So they're like, well, great. Now
did
we have
you
to
find it fishy
do something else.
When they announced that night, McFoley was like, I think we need to ban tag team partner partners and friends, or whatever Mick said.
But just because of Enzo and Jericho and all
it,
that.
It made it to where it removed the, oh, something's going to happen element. So that whenever Triple H shows up, you're like, oh, he's not a tag partner. He's not a manager.
But
so.
It didn't make you think that someone else was going to show up that wasn't supposed
Honestly,
to.
Honestly, no, it didn't make me. I forgot he said it.
Yeah, so, I mean, the match itself was great. You know, and a lot of people are complaining about the ending, which, you know, I can see to their complaints. But it didn't really bother me that much. It was like, oh my gosh, what is happening here? Like, holy crap, he just took out Roman Reigns. The crowd's going nuts. Oh my gosh, he's turned on Seth Rollins. The crowd's going even more nuts. And, you know, to like you said, maybe have Owens be the baby. Like, turn Owens baby face. Because the crowd was chanting, you deserve it there at the end.
And it didn't fit with, like, the way that he won.
Yeah. So, you know, I you know, don't get me wrong. I am ecstatic that Kevin Owens won, you know.
Me too. I think he was the correct person to put it on in spite of. Clearly, he was not the plan. Clearly, the plan was to stick with Finn, but shit happens. I think he was the right choice. I just don't know. I don't like the way they went about it. Because you guys say you don't have a problem with it, but tell me in 6 months, if we get 6 months of this authority shit with Kevin Owens, tell me how you're going to feel then.
Yeah. I mean,
I may feel different, yeah. If it plays out the way, you know.
Yeah, it's all going to depend on what they do with Triple H and Seth Rollins. If they do decide to slow burn it all the way to Mania, that's going to get tired really fast.
But, I mean, maybe Mania is not the end goal. Maybe it's Survivor Series or whatever. It's like, I mean, I think the end goal is he's going to lay down for Rollins and then.
Sure, and that, you know, that would be his. That would maybe be Triple H's. Well, no, he signed on another, like, multi-year deal.
He has, like, a talent
he?
Contract.
Lord. Well, there goes that.
You're never getting rid of
Triple
H. That's
like a corporate contract and a talent contract.
I was expecting, like, maybe Mania to be a swan song, go out with Rollins and all that. No. Nope,
you're never getting rid of Triple H, son.
Never.
Well, here's the other problem.
Let's win the title, son.
Here's the other way of looking at the Triple H thing. It's very much the same thing as when he comes out at the beginning of an NXT thing and is like, hey, look at all this greatness I bestowed.
Look what I've done.
Check out my balls.
Look at all. You like these people? I'm the dude who brought him here. Don't you look? Isn't Vince such a dummy? He's old
Me.
And up in the hill. I'm the guy who brings the cool shit.
Me.
This is very much him. This is like another way of him doing it.
I'm a cool hip dad.
I mean, this is him saying like, oh, you guys like Kevin Owens? Don't you motherfuckers know I brought him here, right? Look, this is me handing him the belt. You guys like me, don't you?
Yeah.
You guys like Triple H, right?
Yeah. Vince sucks. I rule. Remember that.
Crazy old man. I can't fucking get rid of him, right? I mean, it kind of reeks of that a little bit. I mean.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Got to be in the picture. And they're going to show all the pictures of Kevin Owens and Triple H throwing up the little.
Too sweet, man.
Too sweet.
You see that, that picture that, Owens Skyped with Balor, whatever.
No.
And Owens has the belt, and and it's like he's on the big picture, and Balor's on the small picture. I think smiling or whatever.
That's funny.
He also tweet or I read it somewhere. Maybe he was tweeting. He's like, oh, I've been talking to Balor. We've been talking stuff like that. And he goes, he wants to challenge me when he gets back.
Well, I'm sure. Challenge whoever holds that title whenever he comes back.
Because when is Balor coming back? When's the estimated time?
It's 6 months, but with WWE, they'll usually say it's a little bit further so that they can bring him back.
Unless you're John Cena.
Yeah. Well, yeah, John Cena would be like, oh, you just had shoulder surgery? We'll see you in 2 weeks.
Yeah.
So, but for Balor, it's 6 months, but the initial diagnosis was 4 to 6 months, which would put him right around in time for the Royal Rumble.
Mm.
So, depending on how his recovery goes, hopefully it goes well. We'll see what the future holds for Finn Balor. One question I did want to ask you, how long do y'all think, you know, obviously it's too soon to tell, but how long do you think Owens is going to hold that title? Short reign, shoot. Medium reign, long reign?
I mean, I don't see like a better option than him or even like a lateral option. I don't feel like there's anyone else.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm a Roman guy. I like Roman. I think he could hold the belt, but the crowd doesn't want to see it. So
I'm hoping at least like 2 or 3 months at least.
Yeah. Let's start long and work our way back, at least long in my eyes for the WWE these days. Do you see him holding it until WrestleMania?
No.
Do you see him holding it until the Royal Rumble?
I can see that.
When's the Royal Rumble?
January.
Yeah, I see that.
Okay. So about a medium reign. Not too bad. Okay. Who do you think was going to be the guy to take the title?
Off of Balor, you mean?
Off of Owens.
Oh, I think we have to... I don't think they know. I think they have to wait and see like what presents itself to them.
Yeah.
I think.
Well, because the only two people that are in the running right now is. Okay, let's be honest.
You got Rollins, you got Roman. Those are two.
Zayn?
You could do Zayn.
That's all I think of right now.
Cesaro, if he wins the best of seven, which, you know, that he's come out and said, oh, we've been.
Is he legit injured or is that just, they're just saying?
No, that's. It's work.
Oh, okay.
So. I mean, there's a few options for you right there.
I actually don't think Zayn is going to win it, but I do think we're going to go back to the Zayn well, not at least while he still has the belt. I'd like to see a Hell in a Cell between the two guys. Hell in a Cell is designated a Raw pay-per-view?
I don't know.
Are they going to do that from now on? Is it all separate other than Mania and Royal Rumble? They're going to come together?
The big four, the Rumble, Mania, SummerSlam, and Survivor Series are the joint ones.
And probably Money in the Bank as well.
Maybe.
I would think so. They'll probably have a Raw Money in the Bank.
I think they said there's like 19 total.
Yeah.
Which
that's a lot.
Good Lord.
It's actually not that. It's actually like not as bad as I was thinking, because I was thinking like
every other weekend. Yeah.
Well, if you take the four out, that's like 8 months, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, and then 15 times eight. That's less. That's just about 1 month for you.
It's like they'll do Royal Rumble, which is both. Then they'll have February, probably a 1 and 2 of Raw and SmackDown. Then they'll have WrestleMania. Then they'll have a 1 and 2. Then they'll have Money in the Bank. Then a 1 and 2. You know, kind of space them out that way.
And a 1 and 2.
1 and 2.
I want to say Backlash. Which is the Backlash is Raw. What is the
Backlash is SmackDown.
SmackDown.
What is the Raw pay per view?
Oh, they said it. I don't remember.
Oh, Night of Battle of Champions or Clash of Champions.
Clash of Clans.
Mm-mm.
No.
They're doing Clash of the Champions?
Yeah.
That's cool.
It's like Night of Champions, but they changed it up because the Night of Champions is every single title, but the Clash of Champions is every Raw title.
Well, it's also the WCW like equivalent of the Saturday night's main event.
Yeah, whatever.
I mean, obviously it's not on a Saturday, but that's what they
called it. I think that's what they called it, I believe. I have to double check.
But
so Kevin Owens, man, I'm glad that the crowd went so wild for him, because I know Houston has been a mixed bag as far as their reactions.
Yeah, if you saw, like, because I watched that video many times, mm-hmm. they posted on, you know, their Facebook, and you see them, and you can see people's face like, oh no, he's going to turn, and when he kicked Rollins, they all went nuts.
Yeah, and one of the things that I did chuckle at during that matchup was, I think some of the audience members forgot that it was an elimination match. Because
no, they didn't forget. They didn't announce it until I think they went to the match. Or at least they didn't announce it until this sometime during Raw.
Yeah, I think they did it at the beginning of Raw. Okay. And then they probably showed the graphic elimination match. But I saw a couple people on the front row. Once Owens pinned Cass, they were like, oh my gosh. And then they're like, oh wait, never mind.
Did you feel like the crowd was pretty into Cass? Did you feel like he had a shot whatsoever?
I was kind of like wondering, are they gonna swerve everybody? Like,
nah,
give him the title? Vince sitting back there, ha ha ha. They wanted one of these three guys. I'll give it to the tall one. So,
did he feel a little weird in that match too?
No, I felt like he did a fine job.
He's not nearly as experienced as the rest of those guys. I feel like they all worked hard to make him look good,
mm-hmm.
but he's still clearly very limited. Like he's very used to like the formulaic tag matches that him and Enzo does. He's got like the big boot, some shoulder blocks.
How you doing?
Empire elbow. You know, his hot tag segment is sequence rather. Is like very much like a pattern of like what
chain.
He does, you know. Yeah,
they showed I think it was online exclusive of Enzo watching the match.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Nice.
You know, he's like, oh, it was my boy. He's going to win. He's like, oh, man, come on, come on. You got this. You got this. And he lost. He's like, oh, damn it.
How you doing?
Wearing J's.
That was definitely one of the high points of Raw. I want to talk about one of the low points of Raw. I think this is probably going to be one of the worst feuds of the year, and that is Darren Young and Titus O'Neil. Man.
I just don't know what to say about it. I don't know why they're feuding, to be honest.
Because they're tag partners. Because they have Darren nothing
Young
else
is
to
trying
do.
To Darren Young is trying to be great again, and Titus doesn't think he was ever great to begin with, and Titus blames all of his losses on Darren.
And that old man.
He's going to beat that ass.
I like Titus. I still like him. I still think he shows a lot of promise.
Yeah.
I like all those guys. I really do. I don't know. I'm not really into this feud that much, but
I keep waiting on Bob Backlund to turn on Darren Young and be like, we're going to make Titus O'Neil great.
I have a feeling they're about to drop it.
Yeah.
I don't know, with the Bob Backlund stuff, and I could be wrong, but I felt like they were doing good at they first began. He was aggressive and stuff, and how he was wrestling, and I don't know. I fell into it, but now I'm not so much right now.
Yeah. I don't know. How do you guys feel about these local talents that they have for Nia Jax and Braun Strowman?
That guy, I think he's in the, Austin or Dallas area? Is that Americas?
Americano?
Or whatever? Because I swear I've seen a guy on the card who looks exactly like that guy. I think that may be him.
Oh, I don't know who he was. I was like, they were in Texas, so I was trying to think as a small guy. I was like, is it JoJo Bravo? Is it
That's what I thought, but that's... He was on that card I told you about that's in Arlington or whatever. Uh-huh. It was the same mask.
Because the bottom of his tights look like Liger ripoff tights. And I was like, you know how JoJo has those Liger bottom tights? I was like, yeah. I wonder if that's like JoJo under the hood or what.
I don't know.
Who do you guys think is going to be the first feud for Braun? Like on someone who's actually on the roster? Because I was expecting Sin Cara to come out after Braun ripped off the mask.
Mm-hmm.
Are you going to say who's the first guy? He's going to have a feud, or were they going to give him a guy?
Well, he's going up against local talent. And
that's, what if he crushes another guy that's on the roster? Are you talking about that, or
just
feud?
Yeah, I'm just the first
gender
actual WWE superstar to
gender.
Come out. A heel versus a heel?
Well, I mean, it's something to squash, like someone who's going to be like, because gender is not really doing it. He's just there to be like to lose, right?
Well, see, that's why I think you bring in Sin Cara, because I was expecting him to come out once Braun ripped off the Americo mask or Americano, however, whatever his name was. I was expecting that to come out and be like, no, you don't do that. Like, that is, forbidden in the world of Lucha. But,
I hope it's not like Neville or Zayn, because I feel like...
No, I don't think it will.
I hope not.
Well, if you're looking for a babyface that you would slot below him, those are guys who would theoretically fit the mold. Although I'm hoping they're going to just keep those guys separate until the Cruiserweights get there and sort of inject them into the Cruiserweight division. Speaking of Cruiserweights, they announced more Cruisers on Raw.
Yeah.
Well, help me out. Ciampa, Alexander, who were the rest of the... Officially announced?
Rich
Swan.
I think that's it.
They only did four. They did four this time, right? Or did they do three? Yeah. I forget.
Sorry to interrupt you. I found out that organization that's going to be on since VIP, and also it's called VIP Wrestling. Zack Sabre Jr. is going to be there too.
Oh, well, nice. Sounds like a nice
DJ Z, Zmion.
Yeah.
Chris Hero, Sanjay Dutt, AR Fox. Yeah, sorry.
Is that in Arlington?
Yeah.
What's that, around the DFW area?
Yeah.
Arlington's Dallas area.
It's where WrestleMania was held.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. It's just on the outskirts of Dallas.
Yeah, I can't make a 6-hour drive after work.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and there's two different events that has different stars. There's one Thursday and one Friday.
What's the name of the promotion?
VIP Wrestling.
Interesting.
I'm going to keep an eye on their cards from now on. I'm going to go find some social
media. Well, I found out because I think Steve DeMarco liked it on his Facebook. I was like,
is that the place that Steve used to wrestle all the time? Because wasn't he?
Didn't he used to wrestle in Florida? I don't know. But Tyler, who do you think Nia Jax is going to have her first?
That's PC. Never mind. I don't know.
Okay, name all the girls that are on the Raw roster. Bailey.
Yeah.
Just name them all. I know Bailey's not gonna be the one.
Bailey. Dana Brooke.
Dana Brooke.
Charlotte. You've got Sasha Banks.
Alicia Fox.
Alicia Fox. Summer Rae?
Oh.
Maybe.
Tamina?
I don't know where Tamina is. I don't think she was drafted because she's out on injury.
Oh, yeah.
Which is also why Luke Harper wasn't drafted.
Alicia Fox or Summer Rae is going to be like the first person. Or like
Luke's going to get a SmackDown, though, because I think they said that Braun let slip on the podcast he did with Austin that that Harper's coming to SmackDown with the rest of them.
He's going to be in trouble.
Nah.
Let it slip, man.
Just like Braun. The Headbangers let it slip.
Yeah.
Braun!
Alicia Fox or Summer Rae.
Cool.
I also read online, someone said that, this could be false, I haven't seen pictures, Eva Marie, like,
dyed her hair black?
Yeah, black.
Whatevs.
Whatevs. I don't give a sh...
You don't?
Okay. Dye it back red.
What did you think about, let's see, Jericho versus Neville?
I don't know where I was for that one. I don't remember.
I thought it was just a continuation of the feud that, you know, whenever Neville got injured.
Yeah, that was the match. They got injured when they were fighting.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's hurt. Damn it. Can they stop with the Gallows and Anderson green screen doctor shit?
Nope. I've read some interviews from them. They said that they're pretty much doing whatever they want to do. I don't know if that's true or not. If they do, you know.
Gallows and Anderson are doing whatever Gallows and Anderson want to do, or Gallows and Anderson are doing whatever the WWE want them to do?
I believe the second one, but sounded like they're doing they said the first one.
If that's the case, that's dumb, and they need to stop.
Doctor?
No. None of that. Put your hand down.
Dana Brooke is like stretching that thing all the way. Like, you're going to hurt yourself. Don't do it that far. It's going to break.
Yeah. I don't know. Doug, what do you think?
So they chop? They drop.
I honestly don't know what you are talking about. I was looking to see if these people had any more appealing cards.
We're talking about the Gallows and Anderson Dr. Green screen.
It's pretty dumb.
Yeah.
They dropped Dana Brooke with Charlotte.
Huh?
They dropped Dana Brooke with Charlotte.
No, they're still together, but Charlotte's like, I can't teach her to win the match. She's got to go out there and do it herself.
Speaking of Dana Brooke being with Gallows and Anderson, did you guys feel a little bit uncomfortable with like Bailey doing so much gyration? Like she seems like the one you don't like do that with. And she didn't like really get really sexual with it or anything, but still it was a little, it's like they went right up to the line where it's like,
and with like Big E right next to her.
It was like, yeah, but that works for them.
Yeah.
Like she is very
she was just
much,
excited to be part of the new day.
Yeah, I don't know.
Her thing is that she's like, even in NXT for a while, it was before she got really serious, it was like she's just really excited to be there and
she
likes everyone. And like,
hey, we want some Bailey.
I felt like it was good to like pair her up with the New Day just because they're really over and she's still kind of new and you don't really know what kind of reaction she's going to get outside of some of the bigger markets. You know? So
small town crowd.
Yeah, she was still really over. Not that Houston is a small crowd, but it's a big town for
Texas. It's peanuts, man.
But it's, you know, I don't know. I just felt like they like went right up to the line, you know, like they could have crossed it.
They're like, look at Bailey.
Yeah, I feel like sexualizing Bailey is a mistake. I mean,
I don't think it was sexualizing.
No,
it was just,
I mean,
she watches the New Day gyrate, so she's gonna go out there and gyrate, and it's awkward and it's loopy and
I don't know. I'm just saying that's why I said they didn't cross the line, but they went like right up to where they could go with her.
They're like, look, that's where it could go, but we'll tone it back just a little bit. What'd you think about the matchup, Bailey and New Day going up against Gallows, Anderson, and Dana?
I thought it was fine.
Yeah,
to me, I mean,
it was a way to give Bailey another win without having it being a singles bout, and it was fine.
We want some Bailey.
I do love that there's so many chants for Bailey. I find that really cool.
Name them all. Do it.
There's the, hey, we want some Bailey. They're like, hey, Bailey. Ooh. I want to know.
Okay. What's another one?
You be my girl. Well, they just chant for Bayley. I'm just saying, man.
Name document.
I'm just saying. You name them.
I can't.
Sami Zayn defeated Jinder Mahal. Still selling the ankle injury, which is good. Good to see. And I like the fact that the commentators were even adding to the fact. They were like, man, if you injured yourself doing a particular move, a lot of people would be very reserved in going back and doing it. But Sami Zayn went back, tried it again, and it worked out a little bit better for him this time. Sheamus defeats Cesaro to take the lead 2-0. That was a nice spot where he threw Cesaro into the ring post. And then,
yeah, I thought they were just having a Sheamus and Cesaro match, which is good, but it felt like the same match they've had like several times at this point.
Yeah.
But I like the finish was pretty inventive and I liked it. I don't know if we need to do the stereotypical he's like down 3 and he's got to come back, you know. I don't know if we need to go there, but
we have to go there. Unless you're going to have it 2-1 and then 3-1 and they're playing 3-2 and 3-3 and then
oh, Cesaro's injured.
Yeah. I mean, they, you know, because he taps so quickly to emphasize, oh, I'm hurting, I'm in pain. So,
I mean, the spot looked cool.
Yeah.
With the hip toss onto the, not the hip toss, it was more like a backdrop onto the apron, into the
ring post.
Yes. Those are the words that I could not form.
That is the word. What did you guys make of the Paul Heyman, Stephanie McMahon encounter?
Thought it was really weird.
Yeah. At first, I was thinking, you know, whenever he said one and then he said two, I was thinking he was dropping $100 bills. I'd be like, all right. Because he pulls out like a stack of cash.
That's
I'm like,
what I thought too. I thought it was hundreds.
Here's $500 for the fine, and here's an advance, you know, for all the stuff that we're going to do that you're not going to like.
Yeah, I thought the joke was that, yeah, it's so insignificant that I've got all these hundreds and I'll just peel them off like ones.
Yeah.
But like, who bundles their ones like that? If you're really rich, those would
someone
be all
someone who's
hundreds.
Looking for a good night.
I mean, I guess
going to the strip club.
I guess the idea is that he's like, I guess the idea is that he's like insulting her by paying her in ones.
It's
or
like the guy,
it's like slamming pennies down on the counter.
I was just about to say, like, the guy,
count them.
The guy who went to pay a parking ticket, a $500 parking ticket, and he pays in pennies. Like, here, have fun. I'm out of here. Don't lose any because I don't want to have to come back. Oh, very weird, but yeah, that pretty much does it for Raw. Anything else to add from it?
Nah.
Nope.
Yeah, nah. Looking forward to the cruiserweights.
Let's talk about how quick they fucking killed the Miz's momentum that he had last week.
No kidding.
Jesus.
Can we talk about that?
Because that
can we talk?
That stuff was hot for, you know, while what's going to happen?
It was hot for a whole week.
And it's like, they're going to address it on SmackDown.
That
okay.
was the talk. Has there ever been more buzz for the Miz?
No.
And they killed that real fucking quick.
They did. Thanks.
I mean,
thanks, guys.
I hope they learned their lesson.
Why Ziggler? Ziggler has meant nothing. People, look.
Prove it to him. Show him you're not a coward.
People like Ziggler. People even cheer for Ziggler sometimes. But you know, but you know what?
Sometimes. On rare occasions.
But the one thing people don't do for Ziggler is believe in him. And that's because he hasn't fucking.
They do believe in
they
him.
They don't believe in him.
They do believe
no,
in him.
The kids, no one buys in.
He's the next champion. He deserves it.
What? No.
They haven't given. And I have my own problems with Ziggler, but aside from them, just looking at it, like, objectively, my taste and my view of him separated, they haven't given anyone a reason to buy into Ziggler as a credible.
But he's the show-off. Every time he goes out, he steals the show.
I believed
and he's that
in him,
damn good.
The only time I believed him in him was when he was the colonel.
I still like him as the colonel.
Huh? Yeah, I do.
That's a credit to Ziggler right there. The fact that should just be his new gimmick. I'd be way more into that.
Sorry, Colonel, go ahead.
But like, there's
Colonel Ziggler.
There's no. First of all, I get Miz can't wrestle Daniel Bryan. They're not gonna let Daniel Bryan wrestle, so of course they can't do that. But of all the people, why is Ziggler out there? If anything, Miz sort of felt like he had some sympathy. It's like he made so many valid points, so people were like, I don't know, man. Miz kind of has a point. But then, so how they capitalize on that is they send like Ziggler out there, who also honestly comes across like the asshole in the situation, because Miz felt like a little bit like right in what he was saying.
Mm-hmm.
And then Ziggler comes out, looks like an asshole for no reason.
Fight me, bro!
Why is he out there, though? Why did he come out?
To prove that he's a man.
No, but he got beat fair and square. He just got his ass kicked. So he's just out there to be like, people don't believe in you because you don't prove it when you have a chance. What the fuck has Dolph Ziggler proved to anybody?
Yeah, shut the fuck up, Dolph.
Well, he did win that match to become number one contender.
It's true. But wasn't it a fluke?
That's not the point. The point is that he won. And
wasn't it like AJ did something and then he just capitalized on AJ?
He's just that damn good. Yeah. He's the show off.
I forgot about that. Yeah.
Yeah.
He's that damn good.
That's the only selling point you need.
Seriously, though, do you guys...
And he does this when he goes out to the ring.
Seriously, how fast do they fucking kill like any heat that Miz had?
Yeah.
It's a shame, really.
Yeah.
I agree with you.
Yeah. I mean, this could have been the chance to see like sort of some attitude coming from Daniel Bryan.
Well, we got a little attitude from Daniel Bryan, but...
Yeah.
But like intentionally going after the Miz, like you'd be like, okay, you want to talk to me that way? Here's a couple matches for you, and to build
up. I don't want a heel authority figure, Daniel Bryan. Then
no, not necessarily that.
I don't want a heel authority figure at all.
Be like, hey, I think we want to give the crowd something to be happy about, so we're gonna have a title match. You against four people, you know, fatal five way or something.
You want to wrestle? You go wrestle on a bingo hall.
Well, they were supposed to do the whole thing where he's on the Miz TV, and they did. They canned it. And what we were left with was him and Shane exchanging
shame.
Word, like at the very beginning of the show.
Shame.
Which I thought was good.
They're continuing this.
Shame.
Looks like they're kind of continuing this whole Daniel Bryan thing. Did y'all watch? I watched part of Talking Smack.
I did not.
I mean, I watched the part where he was like, yeah, I mean, he's right. I'm a coward. If I had any guts, I would quit. And
well,
then,
also, they're talking to AJ.
Quit!
And at the end, AJ goes, yeah, I'm better than you, Daniel Bryan. Yeah, we should have a fight and stuff like that. And then that's when Renee was like, no, we can't. He goes, I didn't say a fight. Non-sanctioned or something like that. He goes, and Daniel Bryan like changed the subject quickly.
Move on to other things.
Well, I did like how he was like, he's like, if I had any guts, I would quit, but I've got my health to worry about. My wife wants to have children. If I had any guts, I would quit. But it wouldn't be bingo halls. I'd be going to wrestling.
It'd be more like the Tokyo Dome.
But
he's selling out all over the world, bitch.
But here's the thing about that. The Bryan situation is very much like the Ray situation where they're not going to release him so that he can go somewhere else.
Yep.
And if he quits, if they can't use him, they'll just like roll over his time like they rolled over Ray's time.
Mm-hmm.
But the thing that was sort of been made light of recently that is like a real simple thing, but no one's talking like that much about is that they're using him on air. So that's fucking taking dates.
Every date that he's on air.
Yeah, that's him fulfilling his contract by being there. So
whittling it down.
Is this motherfucker going to get wrestle again? Whatever. I think he's playing it cool. I think he's just going to play it cool. It's like, yeah, whatever. And then when he's out, he's like, fuck it. I'm gone.
Well, with all the interviews that have been coming out with him saying, be like, dude, I almost had a nervous breakdown because I was in the business, but I couldn't take part, you know?
Well, it's like he said it on the show. He's like, I feel like I'm healthy. And every doctor I've talked to feels like I'm healthy. And I've heard like Meltzer talk about this where it's like the science is experimental. It's the kind of thing where you go, you're supposed to get tested, and then you're supposed to come back and check in again and see like how you've done in the meantime. Because it's like I don't want to be a know-it-all who doesn't know anything. I'm obviously speaking about something I don't understand with these like tests. But from what I understand is that it's not a exact science. It's experimental.
Yeah.
And he feels like he's healthy. A lot of doctors feel like he's fine. WWE is not going to clear him. If they run out of his contract, I used to feel like when it happened, I thought he's done. But I don't know if he's done. I think he might just play it cool and run out of his contract.
Yeah. I'm right there with you. He's similar to how CM Punk was before he finally just got burnt out. He, you know, it doesn't matter where it is, when it is, he'll compete as long as he's allowed to. And so I think once, you know, like you said, once he gets all of his dates off of his contract and he's free to go if he wants, they might come back and say, hey, we'll offer you this pretty sweet contract if you say, and he's going to be like, nope, I'm out of here. I'm going to a ring.
Huggers?
I'm going to the bingo hall down the street, and they're going to give me a broom, and we're just going to go 20 minutes and see who shows up.
I mean, obviously, I don't want to be that guy.
Five-star match.
If he actually is in danger, I don't want to be selfish.
Sure.
But if he thinks he's healthy and, like, it's not an exact science, like, what is... There are people...
Well,
when you look at guys like Bubba Ray, those are dudes who've had a lot of fucking concussions, too.
Yeah.
And they were welcome back to their roster.
Tommy Dreamer.
Yeah. Had a lot of fucking concussions himself.
Yeah.
Yeah. There's people on that. The thing that sticks in my crawl and pisses me off about it is that they're not testing everyone on the roster. Like,
right.
And if they did, it'd be real fucking bad news for their whole company.
Mm-hmm.
So if it was a high and mighty thing, why aren't all these guys and girls getting tested all the fucking time?
Yeah.
Because there would be no wrestling.
When was the last time Cena was tested? Because yeah. he was still in that group where, like, they were taking chair shots to the head and God knows how many, you know, concussions he's had over the years.
Oh, if it happens with him, they're going to keep it hush-hush.
Exactly.
Anything. Except for surgery.
You know. But it could be any of the guys. Like, yeah, nowadays they're like, okay, you got a concussion, take a few weeks off, and we got to see how you're doing. But, my God.
I don't know, man. I'm sort of, maybe it's just like the me being a huge mark for Daniel Bryan, but like, I kind of feel like he's not done. I kind of feel like he's just biding his time.
I think I could see that. I could definitely see that.
So, okay, what's your theory of when he gave that speech and he was crying and all that stuff?
Well, I think, like, everyone can get to these places, like, emotionally to where you feel like you've reached the wall, like you're not going to get past it. And maybe he didn't see an end to the tunnel then, and maybe now he sees a little bit more clearly. Maybe it's, like, emotional. It's just like, you know, when you're frustrated and mad and you can't fucking get done what you need to get done or want to get done, and you just don't feel like there's a way out of it, and maybe he felt like that, and maybe now he sees like there is a lot.
Is Daniel Bryan kind of like I'm not exactly comparing him, but he's kind of like, you know, Ric Flair. Hey, I've always wanted to wrestle and nothing, you know,
yeah,
you know, no matter what, I'm going to wrestle and do what well, he's not doing it now, but he would if he could.
Yeah, I mean, clearly he says as much. He's like, that's all I ever wanted to do. So it's a huge blow to me to ask me to be around it and tell me I can't do it.
Do you think, okay, so we've established that he is burning through his dates.
No, that's just me, pure speculation. That's not even me saying I think that's what he's doing. I just, like, you know.
Well, no, what I'm saying is, like, we know that he is appearing on SmackDown, so that's got to be eating into part of his contract.
Yes.
Do you think being on the Cruiserweight Classic is taking up a couple extra days as well?
I don't know if he consulted a lawyer and something, is like, just take the on-air shit that they, and it will burn up your contract or what?
Yeah.
Or if he just like had an epiphany himself one day,
or if there's just a clear cut, this is when it ends.
Or if he was just like, I got to keep making money somehow. And then it maybe, like, as he was doing it, he realized, I don't even know if he realized, this is me just speculating, I don't even know if that's what he's doing. I'm just saying.
I'm also pretty sure that his stint in WWE and all that stuff, he's probably saved up a good penny. So
yeah,
he wants to wrestle again, so he's going to go wherever.
He's obviously a thrifty guy.
Yeah. Yeah. He has a garden in his backyard, so he's okay.
He may not be like Mick Foley thrifty, but he's like, he's thrifty. I'm sure.
So,
between the money, him and, pre-made, I think they're okay.
Oh yeah, and their money that they're making with the Total Bellas and all that, I'm pretty sure they're going to be set for quite some time.
The merchandise they have,
yeah. Merchandise and all that, yeah. Let's change the tone a little bit, because I feel like we got a little somber with how Miz went, and, you know, we got into Daniel Bryan. Let's talk about something a little more entertaining. That being Heath Slater and Rhino. Trailer time. You know, wow.
Yeah, I mean, it's strange to see them giving so much focus to, like, Slater.
Yeah.
And it's so weird because he could have just been, like, one of those, like, middle-of-the-pack people who got drafted and, like, people forget that whoever is also on this brand or that brand or whatever.
Bo Dallas and Curtis Axel who got drafted and we haven't seen since.
Right, but by being the last... By being the last guy, it made him, like, stick out, you know?
Yeah.
Like,
He stuck out and has somehow won over the crowd with it. Well,
I feel like he's been popular for a while now.
Yeah, every time he comes up with his little gimmicks, you know, the Slater Gator, the 3MB, the Social Outcast, like every group that he's been part of, he's done something that's gotten the crowd.
He's always been entertaining to me.
Yeah. And now,
I'm not gonna say always. I feel like I even remember specifically on the show, like when he first started being like, "All right, okay, tell me what the appeal is of Heath Slater," because I don't get it.
Well, yeah, NXT
I get it.
The Nexus and the Core.
Yeah, that. But after that.
Yeah, but really, like, I don't feel like people had a reason to like him, like in like the Core or whatever. But people liked him, and I was like, please tell me what the appeal of Heath Slater is in the Core or whatever.
He was just a lackey.
Yeah, but I don't know.
He was second place to Ezekiel Jackson.
And I also sort of like how Rhino is just sort of like there. He doesn't seem to be really invested in it. And yeah. Like, he's just sort of like,
he's there for the hors d'oeuvres.
You know, I'm supporting my family and Rhino's helping me. You're gonna help me
I wish
get
you
a double
meet the
wide.
Kids. I wish you could meet all the kids. They're out in the backyard right now.
I liked how
they're at school? No, they're picking up tin cans.
I liked how instead of like the people who have like Cesaro or Hugger section signs, they had like the Heath Slater's kids signs. Yeah. Or whatever.
I didn't see that.
That was great.
You know, like they do the Cesaro. There's a bunch of people that have like Slater's kids.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
They're picking up cans.
But yeah, man, they're definitely starting to win over the crowd.
I thought that they were gonna lose to the Headbangers in the first round, and like they're gonna play out. But I guess they're gonna let them get to the finals at least, huh?
Well, here's the thing: it's like. So the stipulation is, in order to be part of the roster, they have to win it all. So, okay, so American Alpha, obviously the front runners. Would they change it up?
I don't know. What is Rhino's schedule? I mean, with him being a
politician?
Yeah.
He's just running. I don't know if he's necessarily.
I thought he had already won.
Yeah, I thought he won a spot.
I'm unclear if he won or if he's campaigning. Because isn't elections coming up, even like local elections? Well, they happen generally the same.
I don't know.
Rhino cannot attend because he's traveling the world.
Here's what I could see.
Nationally campaign.
I could see them letting Heath and Rhino win, and I could see the Usos like cheating to beat American Alpha and then going full blown heel in this next week, you know?
Yeah.
I could see that, and then having
Usos
Usos and Slater, and because I don't see he's really gotten himself over, so I don't see any reason to like not run with him right now. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And it's not like American Alpha is going to be like any less, like people aren't going to like them any less.
Yeah, they weren't even on Raw. On SmackDown this week, so
right.
They didn't get
they're not
any
on Raw
kind
either.
Of showcase. Yeah, they're definitely not on Raw. You're never going to see them there. So you know you're getting more focus on Heath Slater.
Would you be mad if they didn't? Let American Alpha be the first champs, and they put it on Slater. And
I'd be okay with that.
Yeah, me too.
They're brand fucking new. They got a lot of time to do a lot of shit.
Oh, yeah, for sure. Yeah. But you're going to have those people who are like, even though they like Rhino and Heath Slater, they're going to boom because they want American Alpha.
Yeah, and that could even set up for an American Alpha Usos feud. You get to the finals, American Alpha causes some sort of distraction that gets Slater the win. Oh my gosh, we're champions and we won the titles.
We're getting a double wide.
And honestly,
start filling up that pool, baby.
And honestly, they could hotshot it. I know like hotshotting a title is not like, you know, a great thing in general, much less with a brand new set of titles, you know, but they could win just to get on the brand and then be beat by someone, you know.
I was going to say, just like the Universal title, which apparently, according to Stephanie McMahon, it's the first time it's ever had the match. So that was kind of weird. And it was the fact that she did it twice, once live and then once backstage.
I mean, we're used to them trying to rewrite history, but that's fucking fast.
Finn doesn't count.
It's like, Finn doesn't count at all. Like, he didn't even have the title 24 hours, so therefore that does not count. Sorry.
So
it's like that Kane overnight reign where he lost it back on a Raw.
Yeah.
So what do you think of Headbangers coming back?
One-time deal.
Okay, so I was thinking about this.
Is it for sure a one-time deal?
I would think so.
I don't know.
Especially since Rhino got cut open from, like, the elbow or whatever.
I thought I could see them sticking around as a jobber team.
Mm. Yeah. Okay, so
they got a decent reaction from the crowd.
I want to ask you a few things about Headbangers, because I only remember a few things. Okay, my opinion about stuff was different when I was younger than it is now. And
about
I remember,
why they wear skirts?
No.
Because men, real men wear skirts.
Yeah. Just well, it's limited shirt. Knowledge of what I remember the headbangers. I remember them, but if I'm thinking, okay, going back in the way I think now, they weren't that great, right?
Not really.
It was just...
Character.
It was like they were big on the character.
That's what I thought. I was like, I don't remember them. I used to have one of the toys. I don't know if it was Mosh or Thrash. I don't know which one it was.
Well, you need to know.
Mosh is the one that became... Chaz? I'm checking.
What are you talking about?
Chaz hands?
What do you mean Chaz?
He had a different gimmick.
I do not remember
after
this.
They broke up.
As Chaz.
No, I think I had both of the toys. Not just one. I think I had both. And my grandma bought it for me. Mosh and Thrasher.
Just imagine a little old lady walking around like Target or Toys R Us.
I'm pretty sure she knew I liked wrestling.
Thrasher.
She just picked. Okay. And I don't know if she looked at the back because they were separate toys. They weren't together. So I don't know if
she took a gamble.
Yeah, she's like, oh, these look like they look. They go together.
They go together. Yeah.
So
they'll just fight one another. It's fine.
But so that's how Rhino was bleeding from the elbow.
Yeah, because. One of them went to attack him, threw a forearm, and it caught him. And then,
yeah, it's what he did after the Beaver Cleavage stuff. He just started calling himself Chad.
He's like, oh, you motherfuckers haven't been in the ring since 16 years. You come in here throwing elbows. I don't know.
Take me in!
They've been in the ring since then. They wrestled for Ring of Honor in, like, 2012, like, on TV and shit.
But this is WWE we're talking about.
Yeah, they don't exist outside WWE.
Well, I mean, they acknowledge all the New Japan shit. I guess because New Japan's really hot right now.
He's banging on the independent circuit.
But no.
Oh, that's right. They do have it in for Ring of Honor, so they don't count. Like, the most high-profile thing they've done in a while is Ring of Honor, so maybe that's why they're like, fuck you guys. You haven't wrestled in 20 years.
But no, then they had an interview. Did you watch the interview?
I did
afterwards,
not.
They were like, I don't know who they were talking to, but they were like... glad to be back and all this stuff. And Lay's like, so when's the next time you're going to wrestle? I was like, I don't know. When are we supposed to wrestle again? And she's like, oh no, he's like, go back there and find out. We need to know when we're going to wrestle again.
We got
to
get another paycheck, man.
You guys have anything really to take away from the, were you surprised Hype Bros won? Cause I was a little surprised.
Yeah.
I think it's a chance to build a new face tag team.
I'm not saying I don't have a problem with it.
Yeah, but VaudeVillains hasn't really done too much.
Sure.
I guess. So I mean, if you're putting two, I don't know.
I talked about this when they were over in NXT. I was like, I'm worried about if
they
get called up.
They dropped the black and white.
Yeah.
They did it for like a second, and then they went to color.
Like, screw it. Yeah, I mean, I was worried that the transition wouldn't go over very well.
Are they going to like turn into like,
It's the Ascension all over again.
What if they're characters from a bygone era and they just kind of move to, like, hipsters?
Yeah, they could probably do that. You'd be like, check out my classic vinyl. I don't know. But,
what's wrong with vinyl?
And absolutely nothing.
That was funny how he said it.
Check out my classic vinyl.
Snooty.
Yeah. Snooty. But, yeah. I mean, it's the same thing with the Ascension. It's the character... that they had and just didn't cross over very well. Just wasn't given a shot.
Those motherfuckers didn't give him a shot.
Yeah. What do y'all think about Apollo Crews spelling words out now? Spelling out his name and.
Man, I don't know.
That was a P U N C H. Or no, that was Morrow. Or was it?
It was both of them.
Yeah.
Actually, it was him. He spelled it. I don't know, man. I want him to succeed, but he's not done much to impress me.
Oh, sorry.
What?
He's burping over here.
I burped and went over to him. He smelled it.
Motherfucker.
Check it out.
No.
I don't know. I don't know what it is that he's missing. It's like he's clearly like not a fully formed act, but there's not like one thing I can point to and be like, this is what he doesn't do, or this is what he's what he's missing. It's
there's
just like,
something there that's missing.
Yeah.
For Apollo?
It's just not correct. It's not connecting with the crowd. Yeah.
For Apollo?
Yeah.
Well, let me ask you a question. Was he over with Uha as Uha?
Yeah. People liked him.
More than his Apollo
character. I mean, It's like a.
I've never seen him when he was Uha.
Yeah,
but
it's weird to be like, who's over in a much smaller, more informed crowd than who's over in a humongous crowd that's may not necessarily.
Do you think they brought him up too soon?
Yeah, I don't think he ever found himself in NXT.
Yeah.
And I feel like.
In NXT, you can work on a lot more things. You can experiment a lot easier. You can try out new things. If that doesn't work, we'll just switch it up. You know, it's no issues. But I feel like they just brought him up so fast, and it was just, he hadn't connected with the NXT crowd that much. I mean, they were happy to see him. They liked, you know, what he did in the ring, but it was still too soon to really make him a star, you know?
He's like, he's a handsome dude. He's got a good look. He's got some, like, impressive things that he can do as far as strength-wise and agility-wise. And you would think that would go a long fucking way. And he's not a terrible speaker, but he's not a good speaker. He's like...
In between.
I mean, it's like he... You know how when someone can't talk, like how I can't talk, like I can't form thoughts, I stutter. He's not... He speaks like someone who knows what they're talking about, but he doesn't, like... have like a delivery where it's like captivating. I don't know what it is I'm trying to say, because I just explained to you how I can't like form thoughts, but you know, he's not a bad speaker, but he's not a very good speaker either. It's like
he's just a speaker.
He's just kind of there.
He's got like some things that are like really big strengths, but he doesn't have like the in-between stuff, you know what I mean?
Whenever I'm talking smack, when AJ was calling out Daniel Bryan and Daniel Bryan was trying to cut him off, because he was saying, you're not a good speller or something like that because of Apollo Crews, and he goes, spell conundrum. He cut him off, and AJ was still trying to talk about fighting. He goes, spell conundrum, we're about to go off the air.
Wow. I do think it's still funny that AJ Styles is wearing the John Cena headbutt.
I love it.
Hey, how's it going? AJ Styles, the face runs the place. You know who I am.
I like how he's just like, what's the word? Since he beat John Cena, how he's like portraying
really
himself.
Cocky about it.
Yeah, like that, like with Dolph Ziggler and stuff. He's like, who do we have here? Dolph Ziggler. I hate losers.
But I'm a winner because I beat up John Cena.
What are you going to, get your little AJ skin in 2K17 with the headband on.
I want to do that. What I want to do is like, oh no, I can't do that. I'm going to do that. Then I'm also going to try to have like early style AJ Styles attire. Like, see if I can do like the shorts he used to have or whatever, like TNA stuff.
Are we going to see the return of John Dynamite?
Yeah, he didn't come back last year, so.
He took a year off to recover.
Yeah.
Go visit the children
himself,
in Mexico.
Define himself.
Yeah.
Yes.
So will this be the year that
it's coming back.
All right. There you go.
It's fired up. Look at him.
Woo! Just talking about it gets you all excited. Bray Wyatt and Randy Orton. That segment ended so strange.
Who could care about this?
Yeah.
Who could care?
I don't.
We got to go to the next graphic. So,
what's the deal that I thought, like I read on WWE.com, or they posted something on Facebook that there's going to be a rematch with Orton and Lesnar.
Yeah.
Did you read that?
Yeah. In Chicago, it's going to be a WWE live event, not televised. So what do we care?
Oh, not televised? It's not going to be on WWE Network?
It's a WWE live event. Nope.
Well, we did get that house show that he wrestled on that one time. We might get it.
Well, maybe. No word yet as to if it's going to be televised. Natalia and Alexa Bliss defeat Naomi and Becky Lynch after Becky, for whatever reason, got distracted by Nikki Bella being attacked by Carmella. Focus on the match, not what's happening outside the ring, whatever.
Alexa Bliss is coming along nicely. She might be able to make something out of herself.
She's going to be a contender.
So out of these six ladies, who do you think is the one of the front runners for the women's championship for SmackDown?
Well, I was certain that they were going to put it on Eva, and that's what all the buildup was to.
Mm.
Because you've got sort of like the more quote-unquote wrestler girls on Raw, minus Becky being on SmackDown, you know?
Yeah.
And Natalya, whatever. But you seem to have more of the older style of women, and by that I mean divas, like on SmackDown, you know? So I could see them just saying, like, well, fuck, if Eva's not here, we'll just put it on Nikki Bella. Mm. Or I could see it on Becky. So I think it's either Becky or Nikki. I don't know. I haven't decided who I think they're going to put it on, though.
Any chance they do a dark horse with Alexa Bliss?
No, I don't think she's ready. I think she's improving rapidly, though. I think she's going to be something.
She'll be there. She'll get there. She'll in be time. There.
I think she's the product. Not the product. Well, I think she's the project that they think Dana Brooke is.
Yeah.
I think what they think they see in Dana Brooke is what Alexa Bliss actually has.
And one of the things about Dana Brooke, like, she's supposed to be the protege to Charlotte. We never see Charlotte ever really teaching her anything. It's kind of like they just show up, Charlotte has a match, Dana's like, yay, Charlotte's the greatest, or Dana has a match, and they're like, come on, Dana.
Well, I think that's part of the character of Charlotte, just being like too,
yeah,
can't be bothered to show or anything.
Gotcha. Gary the Milkman Millman.
That was a weird situation. So just because they got AJ to come out, and he was already on commentary when this guy was already in the ring.
Yeah.
And then I was like, okay, it's a jobber. I was like, I can't think of anyone who's going to job to, though.
It's not a jobber. It's a local talent. Local enhancement.
Sorry. Yeah. Forgot about that.
Enhancement talent.
So
who is local?
I was like, who's new that's going to be on the roster? Who could it be? And then Kane come out. I was like, damn it.
Don't forget he's on the show.
They're still doing this shit with Kane?
Yes. Yes,
I rolled
are.
My eyes.
Did y'all forget about Kane?
I did.
Fuck you.
And I forgot about Tidy White.
Forget about Demon King. It's all about Demon Kane. Mm. Yeah.
Tidy Whities.
Tidy Whities, Gary. Gary the Milkman Millman. That was weird.
That is like the most
run-of-the-mill man.
No, I can't think of the last time they gave some like jabroni the mic and just let him talk. Oh, I was like, this is the most like outside of the box of job match they've done in years, for sure.
I'm here and I want a match.
Yeah. Americo didn't even talk in his little segment. He was like, what do you think you're going up against Braun? Braun! All right, thanks for the interview.
Yeah. So when did they do that with a job guy? I don't know. It seemed weird. I liked it, though, but it was sort of like, they really just like, even if you were like a job guy, like some local, even if you buy into the notion that in kayfabe terms, they have like local talent, even if you buy into that, they don't let those jabronis just walk out of the ring. That would be, they would, if that really existed, like in kayfabe, that they have local talent to use, and one of them went out to the ring with a live mic, he'd be treated like a fucking fan jumping. They would have beat his ass and drag him to the back. You know?
Who's this fucker? Oh, we were not, no one told us about this guy. We thought he was just some dude getting the ring.
I did chuckle a bit at JBL. Like whenever he started taking his shirt off and his pants, and he was down to his tidy whities. He's like, oh my God, we don't want to see that. Put that away. I got family that watches the show. I'm like, dude, there are guys wearing the exact same thing, but they're called, you know, trunks.
Yeah. No different.
Yeah.
I mean, a little more see-through, but.
Yeah. Not enough sequins. I think that's what it was. It wasn't blinged out. It was just white. I mean, look at Bo Dallas.
No, like I said, I didn't expect Kane, and I said bullshit when I saw Kane.
Bullshit. So.
That was like a quick segment, and I didn't know why they need AJ. I
guess, time filler.
Yeah, time, and they didn't want to. I guess they didn't have time because, what's it called, for the main event? They came in when Kane was walking out, so I guess they didn't have time for AJ to come.
Well, he did a nice stare down between Baron Corbin and Kane, so that's going to be one of those.
Oh, that's something.
There's a
see.
Feud for you, the oh battle of the big men.
Pass. But hey, I wouldn't put him past him to do that shit.
Passing of the torch. Passing of the big men.
Passing of I don't give a shit.
Oh. Okay. Well, Dean Ambrose went up against Baron Corbin.
I can't be doing that. I can't be watching Kane matches. Come on. I didn't realize how sublime my life had gotten having forgotten about Kane.
What was that, the last pay-per-view we went to? We're in Houston and we were like, shit, Kane came out and he's going to verse like Seth Rollins, and it was the feud, and we were like leaving and we were like, shit.
It had to have been a Raw or something, or maybe a TLC.
Better to forget these things.
Yeah. Don't worry about it. Let it go. No, because the TLC match that we saw, it was CM Punk versus The Shield and Daniel Bryan versus the Wyatt family during that whole time. Don't you dare do that again.
What? This?
Okay, you're doing Shinsuke. I'll allow that.
That's what I've been doing.
Okay.
Oh, you thought I was doing this.
God, I hate you.
I don't even know what that is.
Well, stop it then.
The
Dean
Headbangers
Ambrose,
did that, by the way.
Huh?
One of the Headbangers did that. Did you notice that?
Yes, I did, and I hated him for it. So Dean Ambrose ends up defeating Baron Corbin via disqualification after AJ Styles gets involved, and then they brawl for a little bit, and AJ racks his nuts on the top rope, and Dean Ambrose pats him on the head. And
shakes his hand.
Shakes his hand. We're out of here, and their end.
I mean, if you're going to do a little comedy, okay, but that was like...
too much.
They let us sit there for too long. No pun intended.
Like, just get off the damn ropes.
Oh,
my balls. What'd I do? Did I stay here?
Yes. You got to wait for a while.
I'm surprised Dean didn't, like, after he did that, run, bounce off the ropes, and just clothesline him. You know what I mean?
Just something. Add to the feud a little bit. Come on, man.
Was it Baron Corbin said to AJ, get out of my face?
I mean, you know what he's going to get, don't you?
Dirty deeds?
It.
Oh, it.
No, he's not going to get it, you stupid idiot. He's going to get the gift of Jericho.
I forgot.
Drink it in, man.
He's going to get it.
Guys, can I tell you, I like Chris Jericho again.
Yay!
I'm into the shtick, man. I don't know.
It.
There's some French for you. Come on, Philippe.
So, like, how he's doing everything plus the little mustache.
Just the whole thing. Like, I thought I was over him for good. I was like, I'll never like Chris Jericho again. We'll always have the past, but he's the, you know, it'll not, but I don't know. I mean,
shows what you don't know about anything.
I know, man. I shouldn't keep talking about all, acting like I know.
We're just having
about
fun. Go White Sox. Don't worry about it. I'm glad that you like Jericho.
It.
Again. He's going to get it. What is it? Exactly. So, time to move into some hot topics. Alberto Del Rio reportedly finished with WWE. He asked his lawyers to inform the WWE that he's kind of done. Not coming back.
So, I wonder if he's going to actually be done with Paige, because they're going to be so far apart from each other. And
or is she going to go with him?
I thought she still has... Can she opt out?
She can just quit.
She can't. He has an option in his contract. She can't.
She just can't quit on it, but she'll get penalized.
She can quit, but she'll get
herself fired.
She should go hit someone.
Yeah.
They can just take their, you know, they can
see
be.
See what I did there? See what I did there?
Did.
Del Rio and Paige can be like, they can, since they're going out and travel together, like Maria and
Bennett.
They could be like that couple. They go everywhere together.
Well, they're actually married, so there's that.
Yeah, that too.
Whereas Del Rio and Paige are kind of just dating right now. I don't know if they want to go that serious and be like, hey.
She's got Poppy tattooed on her fucking fingers.
She does.
Poppy. Whenever they, if they separate, I wonder how she's going to cover up that tattoo.
She's just going to be like, oh, that doesn't mean that. It's something else in my life.
It just means, it means like dad, right?
So yeah, I think that's what it means.
She's like, hey, I like Poppy from Castle Ole.
Yeah.
That's with an O. Hers is with an A.
Or I thought it was Papa.
I think hers is, I think Castle Ole Poppy is like P-O-P-P-I. And hers is like P-A-P-I. I might be wrong about that.
Yeah.
I want Castle now.
Let's go get some queso.
That's good.
In sad news, Mr. Fuji passed away over the week.
God damn, dude. We keep losing him.
2016, man.
Yeah. Who else passed away? Oh, Gene Wilder. Like, holy crap. Willy Wonka. Really, dude? Come on.
I mean, sadly, we're just at that place in our lives where when you were a kid or when you were a little bit younger, you know these people are passing away. You know they have significance to someone's life. They don't have significance to your life.
And like when John Lennon passed away or Elvis Presley died, like your parents were very distraught.
Right.
And now it's starting to happen to our generation.
Like, now people that mean something to your life are passing away, and it's like really weird. It's like a head fuck, man.
It's the fact that it's a lot of celebrities happen this year in particular.
You know, the truth is, I think it's always been like this. I just think we hit the age where everyone of significance that dies, we know a lot about. You know?
Yeah. The age of, you know, fast media to let you know more about everybody instead of just what you see Instead of what you just see at the movie theaters, now you're seeing all the interviews, everything about their life.
Newspapers, and, yeah, internet.
Now you find out everything about the person, so it has even more
you have
deeper
a phone
effect.
In the palm of your hand, you can get on the internet. You're seeing it constantly.
But yeah, so sad to see Mr. Fuji pass away. You know, what a guy. But other hot topic news we have for you: Bo Dallas reportedly was asked to be removed from a plane after getting a little drinky-drinky with some of the other talent.
Singing Lion King,
calling Seth Rollins a dick.
Dick?
That guy's a dick. And I just can't wait to be king. Believe! That's how I imagine it.
You're not fighting Ben Wang anymore.
No. So, anyways, that brings us into WWE 2K17 news. So, Mr. Hebert, would you like to assume the helm? And
I will assume the position.
Go over the list of the next releases for 2K17.
Yes, the last roster release. Well, I have a feeling that there's going to be some people that are on the roster they didn't announce. Like,
there will
they've
be
done,
many more.
They've done that before. In
DLC
like the,
and all
well,
that.
What I mean is there's some people who've been released. They don't announce when they do the roster release. Like, I don't know what's the deal with Ryback, if he's in the game or not. Could be. Or maybe he's removed.
Maybe. That's more of a call in 2K games more than anything, I would think.
Who knows? Okay.
And Damian Sandow.
When did he get released?
A little more than 90 days ago.
He may be in there. I don't know. Okay. This week is Asuka, Bayley, Big Boss Mane, Buddy Murphy, Cactus Jack, Dean Ambrose, Diesel, Dude Love, Dusty Rhodes, Goldust, Jack Swagger, John Cena, Kane, Kevin Owens, Lex Luger, Luke Harper, Mankind, Road Dogg, Jesse James, Roman Reigns, Seth Rollins, Stone Cold, Steve Austin, Undertaker, Vader, and Wesley Blake.
Neat.
Which I've always been a big fan of New Age Outlaws, so I'm glad they put Road Dogg Jesse James in it, because last year...
You're just going to have them taunt suck it the whole time.
Yeah, well, that's true. But last year, they had Billy Gunn and X-Pac, but no Road Dogg, which was weird. But
did they have X-Pac this year?
No X-Pac.
So now they got Road Dogg and Billy Gunn, but no X-Pac.
I'm fine with the New Age Outlaws.
What?
Yeah. So, but we don't
what about
know.
About making some noise.
Make some noise.
Make some noise.
But there's some people that are missing. I know Mojo Rawley's missing because
he's got to get hyped.
He's probably gonna be DLC. I think so. Yeah, they still haven't announced like the DLC, like, you know, like months after the game. That's what's coming out. Not like the Shinsuke, Cruz, and Nia Jax stuff like that, but. Other things, but I'm super pumped.
She's not like most girls.
She's not. So I was thinking of making a roster full of ROH past talent.
Mm.
I was like, okay, let's see how many I could do.
ROH versus TNA versus WCW.
You could do
versus
that.
WWE.
Okay, so we got what's his name? AJ Styles.
Uh huh.
Daniel Bryan.
Uh huh.
Cesaro.
Uh huh. Seth Rollins.
Seth Rollins. Samoa Joe. I don't know if Dean was ever in ROH.
No, he was CZW.
I had some other people. I can't think. Top of my head. Who else was in ROH?
Christopher Daniels.
No. Well, he was, but...
Rhino.
Dang it. I thought I'd count about, like... Oh, Kevin Owens.
Yeah. El Generico.
Oh, Sami Zayn. Yeah.
Christopher Daniels. Kazarian.
But no, I forgot some of the other people, but like in my head, you can make like a ROH roster or you can make like a TNA roster stuff. So, oh man, I'm just so pumped.
We'll get to see your all-star list.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's what we'll need to do. We'll need to have, you can give us like breakdowns of all of the people who are in each organization. Put them in little factions together.
I was thinking about,
and then we can have Tyler's all-star list.
In universe mode, like, make certain people part of, like, NXT. Like, put Daniel Bryan with NXT with, like, Shinsuke, Samoa Joe. Put AJ Styles in there, too. And it'll just be, like, a fun little thing going on. I'm so pumped for the game.
Interesting.
And time goes by slowly.
Yes. But you're getting one day closer every day.
Shit. Slowly. Just be patient. We're like 40-something days.
That's a lot closer than 50.
Good point.
So,
but this is the last of the roster reveal, so I don't know what they're going to... Well, that's... That's what they said.
DLC releases and all that.
So they haven't said, I guess they're going to do it next week, release more information about the game, maybe some more video clips.
DLC.
That's what I want to see. I want to see more entrances. Just Why? Because.
Save it for the game.
No.
It's like whenever you watch a movie trailer that gives out too much info. You know?
I don't give a shit.
Who are you talking to right now?
I'm talking to Tyler mostly. But
Who wants to know about the whole fucking story of the movie before he sees it?
That's why I'm trying to tell him. Like,
well, I'm just saying, why would you be surprised that he would be like, let me see everything there is to see?
I want to see Shinsuke's.
He wants to see
entrance.
It all. All right, whatever.
I want to see everything, man. Then I'm going to play it.
There have been movies that gave away pretty much everything in the movie trailer.
And beat some ass.
That's kind of disappointing.
Yeah.
So there you go.
SpongeBob.
Oh?
Yep.
Okay.
Okay, I'm done.
So with that being said, it's time to go into the Q&A portion of the show. Your questions, our answers. First question coming to us from...
Victor. Okay. Oh, so I'm going to read it because I'm in this position.
Yeah, you are in the spot.
Thanks again for the awesome show, guys. My question might be hard to answer, but I'm curious, so I have to ask. Prior to a few months ago, I couldn't remember a time when so many superstars were out on injury. I felt like half the roster was off healing at home. Can you recall another time in history when the many people were out on sidelines, and why do you think it occurred in the first place?
I honestly can't.
Yeah.
And I feel like I'm as tuned in to what's going on as I've ever been. So if I can't, that probably means no, but I'm not for certain. But as far as why, I think it's just that...
It just happens.
The style has evolved to where, first of all, they're wrestling, like, you know, probably like 4 days a week or something like that.
Yeah. They're on the road like 250 to 300 days a year.
Name all the people who's injured.
The style and plus the style
over the course of the past year, where like half of the roster was out for Mania.
Yeah.
Well, what do you think of what was that interview with Bret Hart said that he likes Seth Rollins, but Seth Rollins is injuring people with the style he wrestles.
I disagree with that. I don't think that he's a dangerous worker. I think that he's just been in matches where unfortunate circumstances has happened. You know,
you said that about Samoa Joe too.
Yeah,
because of Tyson Kidd. Yeah,
the breaking of John Cena's nose, that could happen to anyone. It just happened. Happened to Cena
with the Samoa Joe with the muscle buster. That was just an accident, or he landed wrong right with Tyson Kidd.
I mean, Samoa Joe's done that move hundreds of times. And
yeah,
that was the same thing with the Styles Clash when he was in Japan. You remember how like with Yoshitatsu and other people?
Yeah, but
people
AJ went on like a little bit of a run, but I think like. Most of the people who's, I know like Roderick Strong was like, I knew I shouldn't have. Supposedly it's that because of like the inversion, your instinct is to tuck your chin when you bump because that's how you bump to like protect your head. But because of the inversion on the Styles Clash, you don't tuck it because that's going to put your head at an angle where he's going to spike you. Mm-hmm. And people that haven't taken the move in a while or have never taken it, just like it with on instinct would like tuck, but that's going to put your head at a weird angle to where it's going to spike you. I mean, I've heard like Roderick Strong say like, that was my fault. I knew I wasn't supposed to tuck my chin, but it's just like instinct. And then I'm sure other people just didn't know.
Yeah.
But I mean, as far as like, I mean, the flip side to the Rollins is injuring people with the buckle bomb thing because it happened to Sting and Finn Balor.
Sure.
I heard Sting on the JBL thing say it's a pretty safe thing. I just did the wrong thing. It was my fault.
Yeah.
Like Sting said that. So, I mean, like Sting is as credible as Bret Hart. You know what I mean?
And Finn, you know, he just, I don't know if it's just misplacement on the throw, but Finn Balor just landed awkwardly.
Yeah,
you know, he tried to brace himself, and some people said that if he had just let himself fall, his neck would have hit first or something like that. I don't know, but you know, it's just a victim of circumstances. These guys are on the road 300 days a year, and they're okay, but every once in a while, an injury does pop up. But these guys are tearing their bodies apart, and like Tommy Dreamer said in our interview with him, everybody's got a bump card. Eventually, that bump card runs out. So. You know, to what Doug was saying about paying attention to the injuries, I can only credit to what I've watched since we really started doing this podcast, because that's when I was really focusing on what was happening. And yeah, there weren't as many injuries, you know, which was late 2010 to present. I don't recall a time before that because I wasn't paying as much attention. But yeah, if anything, I think they should make Seth Rollins embrace that. Be like, yeah, you want to step in the ring with me? I've ended Sting's career. I've put Finn Balor on the shelf. I broke John Cena's nose. I injured Sami Zayn. You really want to get in the ring with me? You know, just wait and see.
Well, he did sort of take credit for the Balor thing. Like, he was like, "This the reason this is happening is because of me."
Yeah.
Also, same thing with Sami Zayn. Because when he had that, when they're all four in the ring.
Yeah, with Owens, yeah. But why is it happening now more than ever? Because the schedule is still as heavy as it's always been, but the style has evolved to like a much more, just like a more...
It's more demanding.
Yeah, it's a more demanding, that's the word I was looking for. It was a more demanding style.
Go back to the 80s when an elbow drop, you know, a standing elbow drop was like the thing. Oh my gosh, that is so devastating.
And
like,
a DDT?
Yeah, a DDT. You know, they would hop onto the bottom turnbuckle and do, you know, a little wrist drop, and that would be the finishing move or something. You know, one of the signature maneuvers from Bret Hart, going up to the middle turnbuckle and dropping a forearm. You know, it wasn't as physically demanding where they're doing the dives, they're doing the high flying stuff.
You know, I guess Bret Hart is used to certain moves, and he's just worried.
Well, no. Sure. Yeah, because, I mean, his career was ended just from a kick. So it's one of those things where anything can go wrong at any time.
Mm-hmm.
I like Brett, but I think he's a little critical and like of people who is like not himself. And I get the Tyson Kidd thing. He's essentially family, so he's protective. Sure. You know what I mean? So I get that, but... I mean, in all honesty, I don't know enough. I've never taken a bump, so I honestly don't know enough to really like break it down. But it seems like there is not 100% validity to what he says because you've got guys like Sting that contradict him on the other side. And I mean, to me, like Sting is as credible of a source as like Bret Hart. I mean, they're both in the same echelon of like respect.
Yeah, I mean. For those of you who are actually into sports, I know Tyler and Doug aren't necessarily, but Teddy Bridgewater this past week, I think that's his name, you know, Minnesota Vikings quarterback.
Notably, most of the times I would say never heard of him as a joke, but I really never heard of this guy.
Yeah, I've never heard of this guy either.
And that's fine. But he is the starting quarterback for the Minnesota Vikings, and they're in preseason right now, okay? They were doing the practices. They were at practice squad this week. In a non-contact accident, he tore his entire ACL. I mean, completely tore it. So, it's one of those things. It was just a freak accident.
You're fucked.
It wasn't anything that there was a hard contact. Someone deliberately tried to take him out. You know, it was a freak accident. He went down. And that's the case with a lot of the wrestlers these days. Sometimes it's just a freak accident. I mean, look at the way that Neville got hurt. Whenever he did... The move that, you know, tore his tendon in his ankle or whatever it was, or broke the bone in there in his match against Jericho. It's a simple flip. You know? Yeah. So, yeah. It's more physically demanding than it ever has been.
Flips are hard to me.
Shit. Get me in that ring.
Simple flip.
You'll see how amazing those guys are.
I might be able to cartwheel for you.
A roundabout.
I'm going to do a flip and land on my face.
Yeah. So, I mean, it's more physically demanding. These guys are still on the road 300 days a year. Like I said, the bump card. You know, you can't blame Seth Rollins for all of those things. He's not intentionally going out there trying to hurt these people. It just happens to happen. It happens to occur during his match.
I mean, maybe you can, but I don't feel comfortable enough with my knowledge to say that. You know, maybe he is, but like I'm not the person to say that.
I highly doubt that he was.
I don't think so, but I don't know so.
I highly doubt he went into that match.
I don't
want
to be a know-it-all.
Looking
I don't fucking know what I'm talking about.
Well, I highly doubt he was going into those matches looking to break John Cena's nose, looking to end Sting's career, looking to, you know.
That's how you get to the top, man. Take out the competition.
You're already at the top. There's no reason to.
I'm fucking around.
I know. But
I'm always going to be on top.
Yeah, that's right.
So one day when you'll have more fun if you mix it up, you know.
Okay, I'll be on bottom.
Yeah, there you go. Happy International Women's Day.
Let me get in there.
Women's Empowerment Day? Is that what it was? Or just National Women's Day? Deadpool, man, come on.
Mm.
Have you not seen Deadpool?
Yeah.
I know you've seen Deadpool.
Yeah.
three
where
times.
Where she fucks him in the ass with the dildos.
Yeah.
She's like, and he's like, nope. Nope.
Yep.
Tried it, not for me.
Strap on, rather.
The dildos. Well,
don't worry, he can heal.
Strap on dildos.
He can heal.
Any other questions?
No.
All right, so that's going to do it for us this week. So thank you very much for the questions. Make sure to submit your questions on our YouTube channel, WNS Video. Also, our Facebook page, WNS Podcast. Check us out on WrestlingNewsSource.com, WrestlingNewsSource.com on Facebook. Subscribe to our show on iTunes by searching Wrestling News Source Podcast.
We're on Stitcher, Beyond Pod, and Player.fm. Just search Wrestling News Source Podcast to find us.
Yeah, we're on... The podcast is on Twitter, at WNS Twitter. Podcast. Daniel's at WNS underscore Daniel. Tyler's at Tyler underscore Aber.
Also, tell me how pumped you are for 2K17. Okay.
There you go. So that's going to do it for us this week. Thanks for tuning in. And as always, for the podcast crew, I'm Daniel Heron.
I'm Tyler Apear.
Sorry, I'm dying.
And we will catch you all next week.
Yeah.